Hello, everyone. First of all, I should say thank you for Lucada technical staff. So I had a connecting trouble, and he prepared my backup PC. Thank you very much. Hello, I'm Takatoshi. I'd like to talk a little about Message Pack. Before I do that, though, let me introduce myself. I'm from Tokyo, Japan. I'm developing MQTT broker using Message Pack, Boost Azure, MSM, and Beast. I'm a committer on the Message Pack C open source project. Message Pack C is C and C++ implementation of the Message Pack specification. Message Pack is a binary data format. It's like JSON. This is an example of some JSON data. And do you see cursor? Anyway, lower one, this is the equivalent Message Pack data. The type and the length information is encoded to the header. For example, 8 means a map have small number of elements. 2 is the actual number of elements. Hexa A means a short length strings, and 7 means the length of string. Message Pack is used by Redis, FluentD, Facebook, Messenger, Uber, and others. But I don't know about recent implementation. Which Message Pack features are the same as JSON? Both are portable. Both contain basic type information. Schemaless. Code generation isn't required. They are a composite data structure. The difference between JSON and Message Pack are Message Pack is more compact than JSON. Message Pack is binary coded. So it can handle binary data without text encoding, such as Base64. Message Pack is easier to parse. It requires less computing power. Message Pack requires a number of elements of array and map. Message Pack also requires a size of string type and binary type. It's not friendly to Sentinel approach, but you can use multiple separated Message Pack. I believe that it helps many cases. Here is a list of programming languages that support Message Pack, but supporting level depends on the libraries. Let's look at code example. The client needs to include messagepack.hpp. A C++ version of Message Pack is a header-only library. The top part of the code example demonstrates how to pack a tuple. We can generate a byte stream that is Message Pack format using the pack function. The first argument of the pack function is a stream. A stream is an object of any type that has a write member function. The middle part of the code example demonstrates how to unpack. We can generate a message pack object from a byte stream using the unpack function. Message pack object is a simple variant type. Although we can use a message pack object directly, it is usually more useful to convert to C++ types. The last part of code example demonstrates how to convert from message pack object to C++ types. Using as member function template, we can convert to any C++ types that is adapted message pack. Message pack provides adapters for basic C++ types and containers, and also some of Boost types are supported, like Fusion. You can adapt your class to Message Pack. The example is intrusive approach. It uses Message Pack defined macro. It requires the class user class requires default constructible, but Message Pack also provides non-intrusive approach that supports non-default constructible classes. You need to define some specialized class template. I don't have much time to describe in detail about that, but Message Pack C implementation can zero copy deserialization. That means if you use Boost string ref and string view, the string view refer to the receiving buffer. That means zero copy. If you want to know in detail about that, please ask me. That's it. Thank you.